It is indeed an honor and a privilege for both my husband and I to be here today and to be in this house and to serve and to have Apostle as our father and the one whom God has set in this house and in this nation and in this city to establish his will, to establish his word. And man of God, we honor you. We thank the Lord for you. We thank God for that which he's doing in you and among us. And it is indeed our privilege today to bring the word of the Lord unto you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So let's just rest your hand right now. Rest both hands on your belly. On your belly and just begin to pray. Just begin to stir up that anointing. Let's begin to stir up the river of God. There's a river that is deep within you. Oh, there's a river that is in you that the Spirit of God want to pour out in this city, to pour out in this land. Let's stir it up. Oh, Jesus. Oh, we receive the impartations of your Spirit. We receive the anointing, Lord. We receive the anointing. We thank you for the preparation that you are doing in your body, the body of Christ. We thank you today, Lord. Stir it up. Stir up the anointing. Release the anointing. Release that which the Lord has placed within you. Do not hold back. Do not hold back. Do not hold back. Oh, thank you, Father God. Thank you, my God. Thank you, my God. Thank you, my God. Thank you, my God. Hallelujah, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, go ahead and take a deep breath. Inhale, inhale, inhale the presence of God. Inhale the fragrance of the Lord as he prepare us to pour into us that which is in him. There is a direct impartation that the Lord desire to do today. Let us prepare our vessels to receive from him. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Are you weary? Are you weary of praying? Are you weary of receiving? You're not tired. You're not tired because God stands ready. He stands ready to pour into you. What is it that you have need of today? What is it that you desire to receive from the Lord today? It is at this moment, it is at moments as like this that we receive from the Lord. When he pours into us, draw from that well, draw from that well. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. You may be seated. You may be seated. Thank you, Father. Thank you, my God. Hallelujah. Okay. The Spirit of the Lord began to speak to us this morning, even as we came together in communion, as we gather at the Lord's table. You know, he's always speaking to us. He's always depositing in us. And as a people, we must be ready at all times to receive that which the Lord is saying to us. We must be ready at all times to receive the impartations, because it's not always going to be at the time when you expect it. It's not always going to be the way you expect it. God is going to come in seasons of our lives that we had not planned for. But if we are willing and obedient, if we are willing and obedient, we will be partakers of the fat of the land. There is an abundance that the Lord is pouring out to His church, to His people. But He's looking for those who are willing and obedient. Hallelujah. And as I began to prepare and to wait on the Lord concerning that which He would say unto us and through me today to His people. And I was waiting and knowing specifically the specifics of the heart of the Father concerning us, concerning where we are, concerning where we are going, not only as individuals, but corporately, to know the mind of the Spirit, to feel the heartbeat of God, so that we can be recipients of that which He is doing. The Lord began to speak to me concerning us knowing as a people that we would know who we are in God's timetable, that we would know who we are in God's master plan. Where are you and who are you in God's plan? Where do you fit in and how do you fit in God's master plan? Because this is God's house, and this is God's city, and this is God's nation, and we are His people. We are the sheep of His pasture. The Lord has called us to come unto Him in this manner. He has convened us that He may speak with us, that He may communicate with us. But our heart must be open. We must be a people ready to hear that which the Spirit of God is saying unto His church. And in order for us to receive what the Lord is saying, our spirit man must be open. We must be hungry, hungry in our spirit, hungry to hear what God is saying. And the Spirit of the Lord is saying unto us that there is a shift that is taking place in our lives, both individually and corporately. The Lord is shifting us. He's shifting us into another place. He's shifting us into a more meaningful state of being. He's shifting us into position. The Lord is saying it is time to posture yourself for the fulfillment of His will. It's a season that we must posture ourselves for the fulfillment of God's will, for the fulfillment of His word. When we look in the scripture, we see how Jesus, when He came into the earth, the word declared that He came not to do away with the law, but to fulfill the law and the prophets and the Psalms. And in order for Him to do that, He had to posture Himself in the will of God in so much that He declared, I came not to do my own will, but the will of Him that sent me. And until that becomes the cry of our heart, until that is in our heart, until that rings out of us, we cannot fulfill the purpose of God. Do you want to be a church member? Do you want to be a church member? Or do you want to walk in the will of God? What is your call? What is the call of God in your life? What is the purpose of God in your life? Are we here to sit on a chair? Or are we here to do the will of God? How will we respond to the Lord? He is the Holy One. He is the Lord God Almighty. He's the Eternal One. When He comes, He's not doing us a favor. God calls us and we respond to a holy God. We cannot serve the Lord As the word went forth earlier, we cannot serve God and mammon. We have to choose. We must choose this day. We must choose today who we will serve. Will we serve the Lord? And if we say yes, how will we serve Him? Will we serve Him on our own terms when it's convenient? Will we serve the Lord because it is that which we like to do? Or will we serve the Lord because we are offspring of the living God? Regardless what it costs us, like the father Abraham, when he had to sacrifice his son. If that be the case, let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. That's the call. That's the season we are in. That's the time that we're in, where God is beckoning unto us. He's beckoning unto us. He's saying unto us, the fulfillment of that which we are created for is at hand. Jesus came into the earth declaring, the kingdom of God is at hand. The kingdom of God is at hand. It is right here. It is at arm's length. You can reach out and touch the kingdom of God as it works within us. Are you demonstrating God's kingdom? Are you prepared to demonstrate the kingdom of God? This is the call that is coming out to us in order for us to be in that timetable, in the master plan of God. We must be willing. We must be ready. We must be available to demonstrate His kingdom. In Romans, the 8th chapter, and in the 29th verse, the word of God declare unto us that we are not called to be conformed to this world, but we are called to be conformed to the image of His Son. He wants to make us. He wants to make us into the image until we conform. That means when the Holy Spirit penned these words here for our benefit, when He penned the word for our benefit, what the Lord is saying unto us here in verse 29, for whom He did foreknow, He also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of His Son, that He might be the firstborn among many brethren. If we are going to be conformed to the image of God's Son, it means that there is a working, an outworking that has to be done. Conformity means that you put an effort into something. You allow yourself, you allow the Lord to work His will within your life until Christ is formed in you, until Christ is formed in us, until we see ourselves as a part of God's master plan, until you cannot tell the difference between the plan and us. Like Jesus, when He walked in the earth, He was and He is the Word of God. He not only spoke the Word of God, but He became that living Word walking in the earth. And we are His offspring, and we become that Word as we walk in the earth. And so that Word has to continuously work in our members. It has to work out everything that is contrary to the Word of God. It has to work out every lust of the flesh. It has to work out envy. It has to work out strife out of our lives. It has to work out everything that is contrary until we are totally and altogether conformed to the image. The image, the image, the reflection of Christ, the Son of God, until that is made perfect in our members. Then, and only then, can we truly say that we are conformed, that we are allowing ourselves to fit into the timetable of God, to fit into the master plan of God, to demonstrate the kingdom of God. The Lord is calling us as his offspring to validate his word in the earth, because the unsaved, the heathen, doesn't know the word of God. But when we stand forth, like God stand forth, and we say, light be, and light comes forth. When we say, be healed, and that person arise, and they are healed. When we say, blind eyes, be open, and the eyes are open, then they know that this is indeed of the Christ that is working in our midst. And that's what the Lord is calling us. He's telling us that the kingdom of God is not in meat, it's not in drink, but it is in righteousness. Romans 14, 17, in righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God. That's the kingdom that works within us. And we are the ones who work within the kingdom of God until that kingdom is totally demonstrated in the earth. In Luke chapter 17, 21, he said the kingdom does not come with ocular observation. Don't stand there like the Pharisees and the Sadducees and look for the signs that you believe should be in place. Jesus said it doesn't come with observation, but the kingdom of God comes with power and demonstration. He said the kingdom is within you. The kingdom is among you, because he came demonstrating the kingdom. Who are we? Who are we? And where do we fit in the timetable of God? How do we see ourselves in God's master plan? Socoramando Roberchende River High. Zoboroshtender Marestiondo River High. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Every word that proceed out of my mouth today, Father God, as you cause it to be released from the heaven, let it enter the hearts of your people. Let your word take root in every member of our bodies today. And let our body begin to manifest the miraculous power of God. Let that word begin to work within our members until we are conformed, until we are made conformable to your image. Work within us, Father. Let that word become alive within our members. Lord, even today we declare that we are crossing over, that we move from the place that we were into the place that you have called us to be. We're crossing over. We're not staying at the same place that we are accustomed to. We're not staying in the place of comfort. We're not staying in the place of ease. We're not staying with those things that we're comfortable with. But we have to cross over. We have to cross over in order that we can possess that which the Lord has called us to possess. The next question that the Spirit of the Lord kept churning in my heart is, what are you in the hand of God? What will you, or who will you become when God places his hand upon you? What will you become? What will you become when God places his hand upon you? How will you respond? What form will you take when God places his hand upon you? We take it for granted that we are born again and we come to church and we go home and we come to church and we go home and we come to church, we come to the building and we go home and we follow the process through life. But the Spirit of God is asking the question, what will you become in the hand of God? What instrument? Will you become an instrument in God's hand? Will you become a vessel that God can use for His purpose? Who are you in the hand of God? In Genesis, the 17th chapter, and in verse 5, in Psalm 105, in verses 9 through 10, in Romans chapter 4 and in verse 17, the Word of God tells us that Abraham became a father of nations. He became a father of nations because the hand of God was upon Abraham. It started with a call when God called him out of Ur of the Chaldees from among his brethren to go to a place that he knew not. And the hand of God was upon Abram, and he moved out and God changed his name. God made a shift for Abraham, and caused him to become Abraham and become the father of nations. And today, the Lord is making a shift in lives. He's shifting you from that place of comfort that you're accustomed to. Abraham was in a place of comfort, and God shifted him. He took him out into a place that he knew not. He wasn't expecting that, but God came. God came because Abraham was righteous. He walked before the Lord in uprightness of heart. Are you walking in uprightness of heart before the Lord? As we walk in uprightness of heart, in holiness, in purity, the Lord will come and He will visit us. He will call your name. Maybe you'll be up on your bed at the time. You might be in the shopping mall at the time. You might be driving along the highway at the time when the Lord call your name. What will you become in the hand of God? Will you be obedient? Will you respond to the Lord? What about Moses? We see Moses in Exodus, the 3rd chapter, and throughout the book of Exodus, we see Moses as God called him in that mountain, in that place where all the sheep were there. And here is Moses. And something began to happen round about him. There was a burning round in the bush. And Moses turned, and as he turned, you see, sometimes things can happen around us, but we don't take the time. And especially in this culture, we can be so busy, we can be so taken up, that we do not take the time to turn and give the Lord our ear. Give Him your attention. Give the Lord your attention. Could it be that the Lord desire to raise you up as a mighty leader in the place of your business? Could it be that God desire to raise you up as a leader in your community? Could it be that God has an idea? Could it be that the Lord has an innovation that He wants to give to you? And he said, let me draw close. And let me see if I can get this person's attention. And he stands there, and you do not give any attention to him. And then the fire begins to burn, but still you do not give any attention to that which is happening close enough to get your attention. Could it be that the Lord has been beckoning to you, and you have not responded? Moses turned aside to see. And when he turned aside to see, then God called him. And God raised him up to be a mighty leader. And Moses' position began to shift. His life began to shift. Everything around him began to take on a new meaning. The atmosphere around Moses began to change. Thank you, sir. That is something the Lord is doing. We will experience it in this house when the shift, as the shift of the Lord is taking place even now. We're on a runway. We are on a runway. This house, this ministry, this vision is on a runway. And the Lord is taking us into another dimension. The Lord is shifting us. He's shifting us individually. But he's shifting us corporately. And he's saying it's time for the mindsets to change. Begin to hear what the Lord hears. Begin to see what the Lord sees. Begin to do that which the Lord does. Because it is by that that the kingdom of God will be made manifest among us. It is by the kingdom being demonstrated in our midst that we're going to see phenomenal changes taking place in this house, in this city, in this nation. Not only in this nation, even in the White House, which is in the nation, yes it is. We're going to see shift taking place in that area. Because God, he desire to raise up a holy and righteous people, a holy and righteous nation, in order that his purpose may be seen in the earth and that his will may be done in the earth. And as this begin to take place, the Lord is telling us that we have a part in this. There is work that we must do for this to come into being. And the Lord said, not only will we demonstrate that which he's saying in the earth, but we must begin to decree the word of the Lord. We must begin to release the word of the Lord throughout the heart of this nation, into the very bowels of this nation, in order that this nation can be revived, in order that the city can be revived, in order that the work of the Lord can be raised up in this nation. The Lord is calling, he's calling for a people who will hear his voice and respond. And the Lord began to show me that this is going to begin to take place by the breath of the Lord. The Lord is going to begin to breathe upon situations. He's going to be, transformation is going to begin to take place as we stand corporately. There is coming a time that we're going to see even local assemblies begin to come together corporately for the move of the Spirit of God in the earth. The individualism is being cut off. There's a shaving that is taking place. There's a shaving. My dad was a builder and he had the plane. And when the wood was rough, he would take the plane and he would shave and he would shave and he would shave and he would shave until all the bumps are gone. And the Spirit of God is going to begin to shave and shave and shave and shave until all the bumps are gone, until he has a church that is without spot and without wrinkle, a church that is mature, a people who are mature, a people who understand the cause of God, a people who understand the purpose of God. The Lord is saying that the church in the West must awaken. The church in the West must awaken. There's a clarion call that is going forth out of the heart of God. And he's saying we must awaken from our slumber. slumber and come into divine and into perfect order in order that he can accomplish, because the Holy Ghost is saying, I desire to hasten the return of the Lord to the church, to bring the church into that place of a mature and faithful bride. That's what the Lord is saying. He's saying, I desire to hasten that work. I desire to hasten the preparation, hasten the work that has to be done, for the time is short and the time is at hand. The time is at hand. What will you become? What will you become in the hand of God? Can the Lord trust you with the call? Can he trust you with the call? The Lord called Abram, and God had to trust him with that call. And Abram said, the Lord said to Abram, walk before me and be thou perfect. Be mature. Come into maturity, Abraham. Come into maturity, Abraham. Come into maturity. Legacy life. Legacy life. Legacy life. Legacy life. Come, 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 come. Come into maturity. Legacy life. That's what the Spirit of God is saying. He's saying, take your shield. Take your sword. Because the time is changing. The seasons are changing. Prepare, prepare, prepare. Take all that you have and prepare yourself, because I'm placing a demand upon you. I'm placing a demand upon this city, and I'm looking for a people who will stand in the gap, who will stand for the city. The Lord said, you present yourself to take the city. Will you take the city? 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 That's the call of the Lord. That's the call of the Lord. That's what he's saying unto us. This is not a pretty corner church. It's not a pretty corner church. It's not a church. It's not the little brown church on a hill. This is a church with a vision. This is an apostolic call. This is an apostolic move of the Spirit of the Lord. The Lord said, when you join up, you join to the call. You join to the call. You join to the cause. You join my cause. So stand, stand, stand in your lot, says the Spirit of God, for this is a time and a season that I'm looking for. The Lord said, if you run with the footmen and you are weary, then how will you contend with warriors that are on horses? How will you contend with trained warriors? How will you contend for the nation if you will not contend for the city? How will you contend for the world if you will not contend for the city? Legacy life. It's time to contend. Contend for the city. Contend for the city. Contend for the city. Change your posture. Change your posture. Change your mindset. We have to change your mindset. I have to change my mindset. You have to change your mindset. Corporately, we must change our mindset, and we must report to duty. Report to duty. Report to duty. The call is going forth. The call is going forth, and the Lord is summoning you. There's a summons. There's a summons that is coming forth from the throne of God. There's a summons coming forth. You must reply. You must respond to the Lord. You must respond and report to duty. Report to duty. Report to duty. Apostle, if you would please stand Please, leaders. Please stand. Please stand. Just stand across. I'm just obeying the Holy Spirit because that's what he's saying right now. Thanks. Let's let the leaders stand. Let the leaders stand. The Lord said it's a change in the season. It's a change in the seasons. Now, what I see the Lord doing, and as I said, that it's not in my notes, but the Lord is going to have us now line up, everyone, rank in order, before the leaders, right, all the way like this, all the way back, like this, one line here, another line there, line up, like a column going back, all the way back, one before each leader, line up, start over here, okay, we have... Would you help me, please? Line them up in a column, all the way back, one behind the other, until there's one standing before each leader. Over here, come. Come over here. Yes. Okay. Come on. Come on. Hurry. Every leader has someone standing before them. Every leader has someone standing. Thank you, Father. Shoboroshtende. Just keep praying as you do. Just keep praying. Jondoromoshtenderede. Joramastiondoroboshtende. Maroshtenderede. Coramando Roberstende, Corondo Roberstende, Corando Roberstende, Mestondo. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. That's fine. Stand there. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, my God. Thank you, Father. Now we'll have the leader turn around and face the opposite direction. Thank you, Father. Thank you, my God. So the Lord is setting columns in place. He's calling his church in rank and order, in rank and order. And he is summoning the city to line up. You may not see all of those who are behind you right now, but the Lord is summoning and he's bringing them in. There's a host, there's a great and mighty host that is coming in. They're taking their place because the Lord is hissing for them. He's calling them. And what the Spirit of the Lord is showing me. Show me my Bible and my glasses, please, honey. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. The Lord began to show me as I was waiting on the Lord. He began to draw my attention to Ezekiel, the 37th chapter. And the word of the Lord declared that the hand of the Lord was upon me. The hand of the Lord was upon me. And he began to carry me out in the spirit. And the Lord set me. Listen to the words. The Lord set. There are a couple of things we need to know here. The hand of the Lord come upon the prophet. And the Lord began to carry him out in the spirit. We have to be in a place where when the hand of the Lord comes upon us, we allow ourselves to be carried out in the spirit, in the direction that the spirit of the Lord is taking us. The Lord carried the prophet out in the spirit, and then the Lord set him. Are you ready to be set? Are you ready to be set? There is responsibility in setting. When you are set, there is responsibility. And the Lord took the prophet out, and the Lord set him in a specific place. But it wasn't a pleasant scene. Where the Lord took him to was not a pleasant scene, but God needed him to be there at that specific time for that specific purpose. So you may think that everything that God takes you into, it's going to be all rosy, and it's going to be all fragrant, and it's going to be just the way you like it. And God is saying, no, it's not necessarily going to be that way. You must trust me. You have to trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, you acknowledge the Lord, and he will direct your path. Proverbs 3rd chapter 4th and 5th verse. You must allow the Lord to do that, because here he took this prophet and he placed him in a situation that was not pleasant. And then God said to him, in this valley of full of bones, and God caused me to pass by them round about. So he didn't just stand there. There was something taking place. He had to see those bones. He had to view those bones. Wasn't pleasant, but he had to look upon those bones. He had to assess the situation that he found himself in the midst of. And he had to make a decision. Either I obey God or I disobey him. There's an entire valley filled with bones that are just lying there. What will you become in the hand of God? He had to make a decision. What will I become in the hand of God? These bones, not pleasant to look at, but here I am. God placed me among these bones. How will I respond? Do I turn tail and run away, or do I stand, having done all to stand? Do I stand? Do I gird my loins with the belt of truth? Do I put on the helmet of salvation? What do I do in the midst of this situation? You stand. You stand. And then he heard the voice of the Lord. And the Lord said unto him, Son of man, can these bones live? What a question. What a question. Son of man, can these bones live? And he was wise enough. As he looked at it, didn't seem to him in the natural. What do you do with dry bones? But he said, Lord, you know, you have the answer. You are the answer to this dilemma. You are the answer to this situation. And the Lord, again, he said unto the prophet, prophesy upon these bones and say unto them, O you dry bones, hear, 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 bones, hear the word of the Lord. Hear the word of the Lord. Hear the voice of the Lord. Because his voice is upon many waters. Hear the voice of the Lord as he cry out through you. Not through the clouds, but through you. And as we look at this passage, we see the progression. How that the bones began to put on sinew. And the bones began to put on skin. The bones began to come together, bone to his bone. All in obedience to the voice of God. And then God was shifting all this time. The Lord is shifting things. The breath of God is blowing in the midst. God eventually told the prophet to blow upon the bones so that they would respond. In your situations that you find yourselves in, God is going to blow upon those dilemma, those hard situations, and he's going to change things. He's going to cause things to turn around if you will not look at the bones in hopelessness, but look at the bones and know, look at the situation that you see before your eyes and know that the Lord is the supreme one in the midst of this. And he can make that which seem impossible, he can change it into possibility. Because there's a city, there is a state, there is a nation, and the world is waiting to hear the voice of God and to see the demonstration of the anointing of God in the midst of us. Will you give yourself to the Lord? Will you allow the Lord to do that in you? If you would do that, if you would say with me, Father, today I hearken to your voice. I listen and I choose to obey your voice, to respond to you, and to become an instrument in your hand. Lord, I desire and I pledge myself in obedience to your word and to your will. I thank you, Father, for that which you've purposed to do in this city, in the state of Florida, in this entire nation, and the nations of the world. Lord, we receive the impartation and the anointing to fulfill your will. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God.